Hi guys, and welcome back to Pass the Move. And for today's episode, we've got a game against Pordenone in the Italian Serie C. We are second place, so we'll be playing against a fifth place team who are 7 points behind us. So winning them would, put some distance between ourselves and obviously the team that's in third is also just 3 points behind. Let's have a quick look at the league table. So what's happening is Reggiana are actually first place, as you can tell. They've lost less games than us, but they have drawn way more. It is 41 points to their 44 with a goal difference of only 6, so it's quite tight and certainly not over in terms of the title race and the race for automatic promotion. Yes, the only team that gets automatic promotion is first, but everyone else from 2nd to 10th is in the playoffs, and obviously quite the risky game to play. But yeah, other than that, the points are quite separated. So from 1st to 10th is 14 points separating, even to 11th actually, 14 points. So there's not much really, separation. It might seem like a lot, but the teams battling out for promotion is, still a fight basically. So since that last episode, which we watched against Modena, Terrible, poor run of form. So we lost against Modena, and then the game that followed was two back-to-back defeats, basically, against Fano, Riccardo Cocuza scoring against us in the 29th minute. And Mantova, we managed to rescue a 1-1 draw, and but we did manage to win in the game that's after, against Padova away from home, 2-0. Nice win. Emmanuel Calio, or however you want to say his name, we managed to score 2 goals, and then Michele Canini got sent off for us in that game, and we had to shut up shop for the rest of it. Thankfully, we did it well, and that's what, 65 minutes worth of game time that we held on. In the Serie C Cup, we managed to go all the way to penalties once again. Unfortunately, this time when you play the dangerous game of gambling with penalties, sometimes you lose, and so we've lost on penalties to Lecce or Lice, whatever. I don't know how to say that either. These Italian names are killing me. But yeah, what followed was another win against Samba. I think earlier in this season we did play them, and I think we did show you. I think it was the very first game of our season. So we beat them 3-2 at home, and we managed to beat them 2-1 away from home. But what followed was a disappointing loss to Ancona, 1-0, and a penalty deciding the game, really. And then Venezia, tough team. We were away from home, expected to lose this game. We weren't favourites whatsoever. And, no surprise considering they are promotional rivals as well. And, just a single goal in the 3rd minute making the decision for us. I've realised that my team play a lot better on the counter-attack than they do when they start attacking. Some teams we manage to defeat easily, but other teams we sometimes have to switch to counter. And I think that's pretty much what we did here. That's why they had the majority of the shots as well as even clear-cut chances. But we took our one chance that came our way and managed to hold on. Now, these are a bunch of friendlies, but it's still disappointing to lose. And the reason why we played the friendly was, as I mentioned in the last episode, from the 30th of December until the 22nd of January, there's quite a huge gap. Considering there hasn't been any other competitions in this season, it's only been the Serie C Cup and the Serie C League itself. And since we're knocked out, quite a gap here of games. So I decided to just do a bunch of friendlies due to financial reasons. We're heavily below zero basically, so I thought maybe a bunch of friendlies would get some nice tickets and maybe some sales, and hopefully we'll be able to hold on. As you can see, projection for the term in terms of balance is projected to keep declining, but if we do win promotion, obviously that'll help a lot, as well as it's just during the season. Once the season ends, then the finances rise again. Of course, you get your competition bonuses and whatnot. But yeah, in terms of transfers, there's only one to mention, and a forced one, really. I didn't really plan on bringing anyone in. We could do some additions to the squad, but I prefer to do my business in summer transfer window, of course. But unfortunately for us, Francesco Corapi has a broken leg and he's out for 5 to 6 months. That's basically the rest of the season. And so I brought in a player from Juventus, Vajebe Sakor. Anyways, the Norwegian player. God, I can't even say normal things now. But yeah, he's very well suited to the league above us, so it's great to have him here. He's even better than Scavoni, who is one of our key players. It'll be some nice competition to him. think Scalvoni would be a little bit unhappy that I bought on someone that's a bit better than him. But yeah, we needed another box-to-box midfielder to play in place of Corapi, and it just made sense to get a high-quality player. Why not? So that's exactly what we did, and he's got potential of being a Serie A player, but obviously we don't see that happening anytime soon with us anyways, because he's a Juventus player. And it's unlikely they will sell to us. But anyways, we got him without having to pay a single pound for him. So it's, you know, a bargain, essentially. And we'll see what he can bring to the table. And I think that's all there is for updates. I think we can just get into today's game. There's a bunch of games left here in the season still. We've only played 22 games. There's still another 16 to go, I think. So that's another two episodes, I think. But yeah, in terms of the top scorer, Calaio, one of our key men, basically key player here, and with a finishing of 13, it's no surprise he's one of the league top scorers. But yeah, let's just get into today's game. We've got a fit side, of course, everyone's well rested, and we're gonna have to give a number here quickly to our new player. But yeah, we are at home, and since we're at home, I always expect this to win. But let's see what the experts and the odds think of this game. And I think they would go in our favour just due to league position. But in terms of league form, not too poorly. Most of the red dots that you guys saw earlier were in the friendlies. A couple of them were in the league. But, you know, we're still just 3 points behind. So we can definitely catch up. And I think our rivals, our top spot rivals, are having a bit of an easy game today. They're playing someone, a team that are in the relegation zone. Yeah, odds are in our favour as well as the experts, so definitely should be expecting to win. We'll see how the game itself goes, of course. You can never really tell. And, you know, we definitely need to win. We'll have to see whether... Okay, apparently we can go for revenge. But apparently we need to see whether we have to stick to the attacking mentality or adjust to counter depending on how the game goes. There's a couple of times where I had to switch to counter to save the game. Ironically as that, sometimes stepping off the gas helps you defeat your opponent a little bit better and hit them on a counter, just because they're always on an attacking side. If you're attacking too, it doesn't necessarily mean that you'll score the better chances or have more possession or anything. But we've immediately had a shot here, but again, no highlights of significance within the 5 minutes. Our opponents are playing with a 4-3-3, so you can expect them to dominate possession, and we will be expected to be clinical and direct as always. It's two shots to two, but we've managed two yellow cards too within the space of 15 minutes, so that's not too pleasing to see. No significant highlight yet, but maybe this one will go our way. And it is Pardonon with the ball here. Fifth spot against second, and it looks like fifth will score the first goal, and that's exactly what happens. We are 1-0 down within 20 minutes time. It looks like we are in some serious trouble. And again, it's just a simple through ball from the fullbacks that exposes us. We have real trouble playing teams that, you know, pass the ball behind us, basically. And once again, looks like we might have to switch to counter to save this game as well. But we do have the ball here, and this is exactly what it is, a counter. So let's see whether we can do anything of significance here. Colley's got the ball, and he plays it straight to our main man, who plays it safe first. But now Sokor, the new signing, plays it to his left winger. Can he put a good ball into box? That's exactly what it does. But unfortunately, Vakio cannot score, and instead he hits the crossbar, and that's our first real clear-cut chance of the game, and that was on the counter. So something to think about. We might have to make some changes at half-time in terms of tactics. Sometimes the players just have to give them a little bit more time, despite my assistant being a bit unhappy with some of the players. And let's see how the second half goes after telling my players off. So I think that's exactly what we'll do here. We'll get aggressive on our players, tell them off a little bit, and hope for a better second half. So we'll switch to counter, but we need to switch some duties around as well. So we're going to go on defend for the fullbacks. Hopefully that should stop the through balls. Both wingers on support, most of the players on support duties, and just one attacker, which is the preferred system for counter-attack. Tempted to say play it, pass it to space and run at the fence and, you know, be a bit more direct kind of thing, but let's see whether these tactical tweaks can go in our favour for now. But yeah, we do have the ball, but again, the highlight just doesn't really amount to much, and clock is ticking down, and we need someone to step up here and get us an equaliser if not the winner. We've only managed one shot since half time. It looks like a couple of players performing poorly, but Emmanuel Callio is the main one. We're going to bring on Marconi, the substitute, who hasn't failed to disappoint us previously, and we're going to take off. We are going to take off Giorgino, but unfortunately his backup isn't on the bench because he's injured or suspended. I think it was suspended. So we will bring on Scavoni and hope he can play there. Evacuo also struggling with some fitness, so you know, two changes to our strikers will hopefully turn this game around in our favour. But yeah, we'll get a chance to see whether that actually is the case or not. 60 minutes here, and Pordenone still leading. I'm probably saying all these Italian names horribly, horribly wrong, and we still haven't had a single shot here. So let's go into direct mode, see whether we can clear the ball into space, into the flank, sorry, and pass into space, as well as run at the defense. Hopefully that could bear us some fruit, and it's immediately given us an extra shot. But again, no highlights, no key moments since that, since the header against the crossbar, really. And it looks like the game will end this way, but as I say that, we're getting a highlight our way. Hopefully they won't win it back, and instead that's exactly what they do. I thought it was going to be a good ball into the box, but we've managed to win it back again. And Sakor, can he do something special? He finds Nocciolini. Can Nocciolini put a good ball into the box? That's exactly what he does, and Guazzo scores the equaliser. Can we go on and get the winner? And he scored through hitting the cross early, I think that was. We'll get another chance to see it here. He does kind of play it early. No, not really. He has run down the wing a little bit with that, but that's exactly what you expect from Guazzo. The target man on support duty makes the run for his striker, for his winger, sorry. He plays a ball, a good cross into the box, into the dangerous area. And we will get away with a draw here by the looks of things. That is still not pleasing. My team are in a bit of a horrible run of form, and I think we'll have to have a team meeting after this. The issue is that they're happy with their league position, of course, so I can't technically say we're doing poorly. Now obviously I'm going to tell them they're not good enough, but I mean, like, in the team meeting, if I say we're doing poorly, we need to push on, they're going to get upset, I reckon. But let's see what we can say. I think we've been doing okay lately, but I know we can do better. That's probably the one to go with. And yeah, everyone's happy with that. That's great. And hopefully now this will spur my team on to go on a winning run. Tons of women will be back, as always, 7 games away from now. We've got, I think I mentioned, 16 games separating the team, so it probably makes sense to do about 8 games each per episode. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then this is the 8th team, and I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we'll decide, really. Probably Bassano's the team to play against, since they're just one spot behind us. And I think the last game of the season as well. So look out for those games, Bassano and Padova, in the next 2 episodes, where we'll be finishing off this season. Let's see what happens next episode. But yeah, if you enjoyed this episode, then please hit the like button and subscribe for more daily FM content. And as always, thank you guys for watching.